Hello students, myself Anurag Goel from Vidyamandir Classes. Today we are going to discuss questions from Binomial Theorem and Permutations Combinations from actual JEE Advanced papers from 2013-18. Okay, let's discuss first question. It is a Binomial Theorem. It says there is an expression given x is equal to 10c1 square plus twice of 10c2 square, so and so forth till 10 times 10c10 square, where 10cr is a binomial coefficient. You need to find the value of 1 by 14 30 times x. Let's solve it on board. It says x is 10c1 square plus twice 10c2 whole square plus thrice 10c3 whole square goes on till 10 times 10c10 whole square. We need to simplify this. Okay, now let's consider the expansion 1 plus x whole to the power 10. This expansion of this contains these coefficients 10c0, 10c1 and so on and so forth. That is, it is 10c0 x to the power 0, 10c1 x to the power 1, 10c2 x square till 10c10 x to the power 10. Now similarly, we have x plus 1 to the power, let's say 10, it will be 10c0 x to the power 10, 10c1 x to the power 9, 10c10 x to the power 0. Now we need binomial coefficient with an AP. Let's differentiate with respect to x. Differentiate it with respect to x. This will be 10 1 plus x to the power 9 0. It will be 1 10c1 x to the power 0, 2 10c2 x, 10 times 10c10 x to the power 9. And let's multiply these two. That will be 10 times 1 plus x to the power 9 plus 10, that is 19 over here. And over here it will be 1 into 10c1 x to the power 0, 2 into 10c2 into x goes on till 10 times 10c10 x to the power 9 times another factor 10c0 x to the power 10, 10c1 x to the power 9, and this goes on till 10c10 x to the power 0. Now let's focus on this expression, that is 10c1 square times 1, 1 times 10c1 square. If you multiply this term with this term, that will give you 1 times 10c1 square times x to the power 9. This is the coefficient of x to the power 9. Similarly, if you multiply this term, that is second term of this first factor, prefactor, with third term of this post factor, that will be 10c2 times x to the power 8. This times this will be 2 times 10c2 square x to the power 9. Hence, clearly this thing is nothing but 1 times 10c1 square plus 2 times 10c2 square, and this goes on till 10 times 10c10 square is nothing but coefficient of x to the power 9 in the right hand side, and that must be same as coefficient of x to the power 9 over here. Hence, get coefficient, comparing the coefficient of x to the power 9, coefficient of x to the power 9, from this you will get, it will be 10 times 19c9. Hence, x value of x will be 10 times 19c9. Alternatively, you can say this will be nothing but another approach of this, considering this is, it is summation of r times 10cr square, and that is r varying from 1 to 10, and you may reduce it to r varying from 1 to 10. It will be r 10cr times 10cr, and this is nothing but 10 by r times 9cr minus 1. This will be nothing but summation r varying from 1 to 10, 9c r minus 1 times 10 cr, and using combinatorial method, that is, if we have, let's say, 9 boys and 10 girls, this will be selection of, if you take R as 1, this will be 9C, 0, 10C, let's consider it as 10 minus R. That is, if you have R is 1, this will be 9C naught times 10C, 10. Then, if you take R as 2, this will be 9C, 1 times 10C, 10C, 9. If you take R as 2, this will be 1, this will be 10 minus 2. If you take R as 1, this will be 9, this will be 8. And this goes on till, if you take R as 10, it will be 9C, 9 times 10C, 0. And you can say that if there are 9 boys, 10 girls, in this is the case-wise summation of, if you have 9 boys, 10 girls, selection of 9 students. Hence, it must be 19C, 9. Clearly, and this will be, and this is 10 times, because if you reduce this using this result, R times NCR, it will be nothing but N times N minus 1 CR minus 1. Hence, it is 10 times 9C9, complete answer as this. That is value of X. And we need to find what is the value of 1 by 1430 times X. What is this value? This will be nothing but 1 by 1430 times X is 10 times 19C9, that is 19 factorial. Let's evaluate it. 19 into 18 into 17, 16, 15, 14, 13 and 12, 11 by 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And this will be, let's drop this 9 to 18, and then we drop this 12 over here. This will be, let's say, 2, 3, let's, and this is 2, and 143 is 11 times 13, 13 also 1. This is nothing but 19 times 17 times 2. That is your 19 times 17 times 2 is 646. 646. And that is the official answer key. That is 646 for this question. Now, let's look at the next question of this advance. That is, it says, let m be the smallest positive integer such that the coefficient of x square in the expansion of this series 1 plus x whole square plus 1 plus x whole cube till 1 plus mx to the power 50 is 3n plus 1 times 51c3 for some positive integer n. We need to find the value of n. Says 1 plus x whole square plus 1 plus x whole cube plus 1 plus x to the power 49 plus 1 plus mx to the power 50. Coefficient of x square over here, coefficient of x square is given to be equal to 3n plus 1 51c3. Coefficient of x square in the expansion is given to be equal to this. So let's find coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square in first term is nothing but 2c2. Coefficient of x square plus coefficient of x square in this next term, next binomial is 3c2. Next will be 4c2. This goes on till coefficient of x square in this will be nothing but 14c2. And in the last term, there is a difference, that is the second term is mx. The coefficient of x square over here, it will be 50c2 into m square. That is, this is given to be equal to, in the question, it is given to be equal to 3n plus 1 times 51c3. Now, use for this sum, let's write this 2c2 as 3c3. Both the values are 1. And we add 3c3 with 3c2 using the standard result. That is ncr minus 1 plus ncr is n plus 1 CR, sum of two consecutive binomial coefficient. This add up to 4C3. these two add to 4c3, then this 4c3 added with 4c2 will give you 5c3, and so forth. The last term will be 50c3 up till 49c2. Hence, and there is another standard, you can consider it as a standard result as RCR till NCR sum, where this superscript added, where we add one true superscript in each term, in each consecutive term, this will be equal to n plus 1 c r plus 1. This sum is 50 c3 plus 50 c2 times m square is equal to 3 n plus 1 times 51 c3. That will be 50 factorial by 3 factorial 47 factorial plus 50 factorial by 2 factorial 48 factorial m square is equal to 3 n plus 1 times 51 factorial by 3 factorial 48 factorial. Okay, now let's cancel this 50 factorial from this term. This term, this will be just 51. Let's multiply both sides by 3 factorial times 48 factorial. This will be nothing but 48 plus this will be 3m square is equal to, we multiply both sides by 3 factorial times 48 factorial. This will be nothing but 51 times 3n plus 1. That means you get, let's drop this 3, this is 16, this will be 17. And that is m square is, from this result, it will be 17 times 3, 51n plus 17 minus 16, that is 1. We get this relationship between m and this parameter m and the n. Now, it's a single equation in two unknowns, and that two are positive integers. Now let's take different values of n, so that, and it says m is the smallest positive integer, that is for m to be smallest positive integer, we need this to be smallest, that is smallest perfect square. For this to be smallest perfect square, it could be n is 0, but in that case m will become 1, and if m is 1, smallest positive integer, if n is 0, it is 51c3. Smallest positive integer, so that the coefficient of x square and the expansion of this is this for the sum positive integer n. Okay, it is given that n is a positive integer. N belongs to natural number, n cannot be 0. Okay, now if you take different values of n, let's say 1, 2, 3 and so forth, you get, if you have n as, let's say 5. If you have n as 5, for n is equal to 1, it will be 52. It will be 52. For n is equal to 2, it will be 102 plus 103, not a perfect square. For n is equal to 3, it will be 153, 154. For n equal to 4, it will be 204 plus 1, 205, not a perfect square. But for n is equal to 5, it will be 255 plus 1, 256, which is a perfect square of 16. 16 square. That is, m is 16, n is 5. Otherwise, we will take some another approach for finding this. It is n is equal to 5, that is the official answer k. Now next question is finding the coefficient of x to the power n in the expansion of 1 plus x multiplied with 1 plus x squared till 1 plus x to the power 100. It consists of 100 factors, 100 binomial factors. It came in Advanced 2015 paper. We need to find coefficient of x to the power n, 9. Coefficient of x to the power 9 in the product 1 plus x, 1 plus x square, 1 plus x cube, till 1 plus x to the power 100. What is the coefficient of x to the power 9? Now this, it consists of 100 binomial factors. Okay. Now you can easily see this cannot be reduced to some single or one or two binomial factor. Let's say instead of 1 plus x cube, if we have, instead of 1 plus x cube, it would be 1 plus x4. If it is, instead of 1 plus x cube, it is 1 plus x4. If we multiply and divide by 1 minus x, it start multiplying. That is, 1 minus x with 1 plus x will be 1 minus x square. Now that 1 minus x square with 1 plus x square will be 1 minus x4. 1 minus x to the power 4 multiplied by 1 plus x4 will be 1 minus x to the power 8. But this is not the case over here. It is just 1 plus x cube. Now we need to find the coefficient of x cube and 9. You can further see that if it is 1 plus x, 1 plus x square, 1 plus x cube, and it multiplied it with 1 plus x to the power 9. And further it will be 1 plus x to the power 10, and this goes on till 1 plus x to the power 100. You can easily drop these factors. There is no point keeping them, because if product of these leads you to, if a naught plus a1x plus a2x square till a9x to the power 9, if let's say product of these is this is 9 degree polynomial. Now multiplying this with further 1 plus x to the power 10, if you multiply that with 1, coefficient of x to the power 9 will be a9. If you multiply it with x to the power 10, there is no further coefficient of x to the power 9 further. Hence, there is no point in keeping these extra factors. Hence, we need to find this a9 in this first product of these 9 factors. Now, as you can see, we get x to the power 9 if let's say from each term you multiply either 1 to another term of the another factor, or you multiply x to this. That is, if you want x to the power 9, it will be either, let's say, x to the power 9 multiply by all ones of first 8 factors. In that case, you get 1 x to the power 9. In the similar manner, to get x to the power 9, let's say, if we multiply x to the power 8 of previous factor, x to the power 8 of previous factor, with this x, you'll get, and remaining 7 ones, you'll get 1 x to the power 9 again further. That means it is nothing but in how many ways I can write 9 as, that is, a 9 will be x to the power some a plus b plus c, where a, b, c came from each of these factors, and this add up to 9, a plus b plus c plus so and so forth. They are natural numbers, that is, it is 1 or 2 or 3. Further, if we have a must be less than b must be less than c and so and so forth, this must be greater than or equal to 1. This is the scenario, that is, we want sum of some number of variables add up to 9, where a is less than b less than c and so forth, where all of them are greater than or equal to 1. That is clear cut of partitioning of 9 in integers in ascending order, unordered. That means let's write 9 as 9 only. It will be this term. We can write 9 in sum of two numbers, that is 1 plus 8, or you may write as 2 plus 7, or you may write as 3 plus 6, or you may write as 4 plus 5. Obviously, we can write 5 plus 4, but that is same as 4 plus 5, because 5 plus 4 will be nothing but x to the power 5 times x to the power 4, and x to the power 5 is only one factor, 1 plus x to the power 5 over here. That means further, let's draw write 9 as sum of three terms, that is, let's say if it is 6, it is 2, 1, 6, 7, 8, 9, and further it will be 5, remaining 4 will be either 3, 1, or 2, 2 is not possible. Further, it will be, if it is 9, sum of 3 terms, let's say 4, 4 and remaining will be 5, that is 3 plus 2, and further, there is no partitioning possible, that is, this term will be when we multiply this 1 with this x to the power 9, we get this. This term will be when we multiply by x to the power 1 with this x to the power 8, second last term, you get this term. This 9 will be when you multiply x square with x to the power 7 and coefficient 1 and so forth. This term is equivalent to x to the power 1 times x to the power 2 times x to the power 6, coefficient will be 1, and these sum up to 9. This sum up to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8. There are 8 such terms in which coefficient of x to the power 9 appears. Hence, coefficient of x to the power 9 will be 8. Okay. Now, the question from Advanced 2014, it says, coefficient of x to the power 11 in the expansion of 1 plus x squared to the power 4, product with 1 plus x cubed to the power 7 and 1 plus x to the power 4 to the power 12. So let's solve it on board. says finding coefficient of x to the power 11 in 1 plus x squared to the power 4 product with 1 plus x cube whole to the power 7, 1 plus x to the power 4 to the power 12. You need coefficient x to the power 11 over here, and there is no as such pattern over here. 1 plus x squared to the power 4, 7, 12. Okay. Let's write down the general term of this. General term of this, let's say it will be 4CR1 x squared to the power R1 times general term of this expansion will be 7CR2 x cubed to the power R2 times 12CR3 x4 to the power R3. And if you multiply them, we get the coefficient as 4CR1 times 7CR2 times 12CR3 times x to the power 2R1 plus 3R2 plus 4R3. 2R1 plus 3R2 plus 4R3. Now, we want this 2R1 plus 3R2 plus 4R3 is equal to 11. That is, you get 2R1 plus 3R2 plus 4R3 equals 11. Whereas R1, R2, R3 are non-negative integers. R1 lying in 0 to 4, R2 lying in 0 to 7, R3 varying from 0 to 12. We need possible ordered triplets R1, R2, R3, which makes this equation 11. Okay. As you can see, R3 is having maximum weight over here, that is 4. That means R3 will take minimum values, minimum number of values. Let's take R3 possibilities. R3 will be, if we take R3 as 0, if we take R3 as 0, this equation boiled down to, this will be 2R1 plus 3R2. If we take R3 as 0, it will be equal to 11. Now, clearly in that case, R2 cannot be even, R2 cannot be odd. R2 cannot be even, because if R2 is, let's say if R2 is 0, 2R1 will become odd. Hence, R2 must be an odd number. Now, let's make the cases when R2 is, let's say, 1. If we have R2 as 1 over here, if R2 is 1, it will be 11 minus 3, that is 8 by 2, 4. R1 will be 4. This is one possibility. If we take R2 as, let's say, 3, if R2 is 3, this will be 9. 11 minus 9 is 2. R1 will be 1. If it is 5, that is not a possibility, because if R2 is 5, this R1 becomes negative. Now, let's take the case when R3 is, let's say, 1. If we have R3 as 1, this equation reduces to 2R1. This is the case when R3 is 0. Now, if you have R3 as 1, this equation reduces to 2R1 plus 3R2 equals 11 minus 4, that is 7. Now, let's take the cases, various cases. If R2 is 1, this will be 4, R1 will be 2. This is 1. This is, if R2 is, let's say, 3, not a possible, because if R2 is 3, then R1 will be negative. Then let's say R3 is finally 2. It will be, this equation reduces to 2R1 plus 3R2 equals 11 minus 8, that is 3. Now, I've taken R3 as 2. Now, it will be, if R2 is 0, not a possibility. If R2 is 1, R1 will be 0. These are the only possible R1, R2, R3 combinations. That means, let's add this over possible R1, R2, R3 triplets. That is 410, 130, 211 and 012. That is, this also implies there exist 4 terms containing x to the power 11 in the product, in this product. Now, it will be, if we take R1 as 4, it will be 4C4 times 7C1 times 12C0 plus R1, R2, R3 is 130. It will be 4C1 times 7C3 times 12C0 plus 4C2, 7C1, 12C1 and last is 4C0 times 7C1 times 12C2. This is 4C4 is 1, 12C0 is 1, this is 7. Plus, this will be 4 times 35 plus this is 6 times 7 times 12. This one is 1, 7, 7 times 12 into 11 by 2, 66. this will be 7 plus 140 plus 42 into 12. 504 plus 462. This is 7 4 11 13 11 11. Answer coming out to be 1113. That is given as option C. 1113. That is the official answer. That is 1113 is the answer. Now let's come to next question. It's of 2013. It says coefficient of 3 consecutive terms of 1 plus x to the power n plus 5 are in the ratio of 5 is to 10 is to 14. You need to find the value of n. Plus x whole to the power n plus 5. It says coefficient of 3 consecutive terms. Let's consider these 3 consecutive terms as tr plus 1, tr and tr minus 1. And coefficient of tr plus 1 over here will be n plus 5 cr is 2. Coefficient of rth term will be n plus 5 cr minus 1 is 2. N plus 5 cr minus 2. These are given to be proportionate to 5 is to 10 is to 14. We need to find what is the value of n. That is what is required. Now, if you let n plus 5 cr divided by n plus 5 cr minus 1, this will be given to be equal to 5 by 10. That is first equation. And we have a standard result, that is ratio of two consecutive binomial coefficient ncr over ncr minus 1 on simplification. By substituting values of ncr and ncr minus 1, it will be n minus r plus 1. By r. Now this simplifies to this is 1 by 2, this one is n minus r, that is n plus 5 minus r, n plus 5 minus r plus 1 plus 1 divided by r. This simplifies to n minus r plus 6, n minus r plus 6 by r equals 1 by 2, and that gives you an equation as 2n plus 12 is equal to 2r plus r, that is 3r. That is first relation. From second ratio, that is n plus 5 cr minus 1, n plus 5 cr minus 1 divided by n plus 5 cr minus 2, you get 10 is to 14, that is 5 by 7. This is again ratio of two consecutive binomial coefficient and having more index in numerator, that is it will be equal to further n plus 5 minus r plus 1 plus 1 n plus 5 minus of this, n plus 5 minus r plus 1 plus 1 divided by r minus 1, and this will be equal to 5 over 7. Now let's simplify this, that is 7n minus 7r 5 6 7 plus 49 equals 5r minus 5. That simplifies to 7n plus 54 equals 12r. That is your second equation. Now let's simplify. We want n. That is, we need to eliminate r from it. Let's say we multiply this equation with 4 and subtract this. And subtract this equation. That is 8n minus 7n. That gives you n plus 48 minus 54. Plus 48 minus 54 will be minus 6. And over it will be 0. You'll get n is equal to 6. You'll get n is equal to 6 as the answer key. That is the official answer key, that is 6. Okay, now look at this question. It says, it is from 2018 advanced paper of permutations combination. It says number of 5 digit numbers which are divisible by 4 with digits from the set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and whereas repetition of the digits is allowed. It is a very simple one. You need to form 5 digit number, square of 5-digit number divisible by 4. Number of 5-digit number divisible by 4. Repetition of digits is allowed, and digits to be used are from this set only. Now, for number to be divisible by 4, the divisibility rule is the last two digits, that is digits at the tens place and ones place, these two digits will be divisible by 4. We need these to be divisible by 4. And for these two digits to be divisible by 4, the unit place must be even, clearly must be even. That means there are only two possibilities for this unit place. It is either 2 or 4. Let's take these two cases only. That is, the unit place is 2 or unit place is 4. Now, if unit place is 2, that is, this is filled by only one way, that is 2. Now, this place will be, it could be either 1, because 12 is divisible by 4. It cannot be 2. It could be 3. 32 is divisible by 4, and it could be 5. That is, the last two places will be either 12, that is divisible by 4, or 32, or 52. That is, this will be 3. This place will be filled by 3 ways. And as the digits are, the digits can be repeated, this place can be filled by any of these 5 now. Any of these 5. That is, the number of numbers with n digits as 2 and divisible by 4 is 5 cube times 3. That is 125 times 3, that is 375. And on the similar manner, this place can be filled in. This is filled in one way only, 4. This place can be filled by 1, not it can be filled by 2. It can be filled by 4. There are only two possibilities over here. Similarly, this will be filled by 5 ways. This can be filled in 5 ways, and this can be filled in 5 ways. Hence, altogether, this will be 5 cube times 2. 125 times 2 is 250. Hence, we have total as 625 total 5 digit number divisible by 4. As you can see over here, official answer key is also 625, but it is also given in range form, because in that year you have answer key in up to 2 decimal places, up to 3 decimal places maybe. Now it says in 2018 again, let x be the set with exactly 5 elements and y be the set exactly having 7 elements. Now alpha be the number of 1-1 function from x to y, and beta is denotes the number of onto function from y to x. We need to find the value of 1 by 5 factorial time beta minus alpha. That is, we need to find number of 1-1 function from a to b set x to y, and number of onto function from set y to x. That is, it says set x has 5 elements, x1, x2, x3, x4, x5. Codomain, that is set y, is having 7 elements, y1, y2, y3, y4, y5, y6, y7. Now, over here, it's alpha denotes number of 1-1 function from set x to set y. Number of 1-1 functions, 1-1. Now, that is easier one. That is, if alpha is denoting number of 1-1 function from set A to set B, there is a clear, simple formula. That is, it will be 7P5. That is, we need to permute 5 objects from this set along with this set. That is, 7P5 will be the answer. That is 7 factorial by 2 factorial. Now, beta denotes number of onto function from set y to set x. Number of onto functions. From y to x, from this set to this set. Okay, now there is a closed form for number of onto function from set having m elements, from a set having m elements to a set having n elements, n number of elements. Number of onto function is n to the power m minus nc1 times n minus 1 to the power m plus nc2 times n minus 2 to the power m, and this goes on till nCn minus 1, 1 to the power m. Or you may alternatively write it as minus 1 to the power r, nCr, n minus r to the power m, r varying from 0 to n. This is the formula for number of onto function from set having m elements to set having n elements. Now on that lines, beta will be, over here m is 7 and n is 5. that is beta will be 5 to the power 7 minus 5c1 times 4 to the power 7 plus 5c2 times 3 to the power 7 minus 5c3 times 2 to the power 7 plus 5c4 times 1 to the power 7. This will be value of beta, and we need to evaluate beta minus alpha by 5 factorial. Beta minus alpha by 5 factorial. Now, instead of using this as beta, because this is again very calculations are involved in this case, evaluating this will be beta of beta is this minus this divided by 5 factorial, and there is no common factor of 5 factorial over here. You need to evaluate this only completely. Now, there is another possibility, because there is a very less gap between number of elements in domain and codomain. Now, what are the various possibility for an onto function from set having 7 elements to set 5 elements, set having 5 elements? If let's say y1 goes to x1, y2 goes to x2, y3 goes to x3, y4 goes to x4, y5 goes to x5. Now, the remaining two elements will either go to a unique same element, that is either x1 or x2 or x3 or x4. Then in that case, one element, let's say this case, that is y1, y6, y7 goes to x1 and remaining goes to only one element. That is, only possibilities are from y to x, from y to x, three of the elements of y, three elements of y are mapped to single element of x, one element of x, and remaining four element goes to one each, and remaining four elements goes to one each of x. This is one case possible. Now, second possibility, possible case is these two elements go to one each, that is 5, 6 goes to let's say x1 and y7 goes to let's say x2. That is two elements of y, two elements of y goes to one element of x to another element of y, to another element of y goes to one element of x, another element of x. That is, now the various possibilities are, that means, let's say from this seventh element, this set, it could be these three elements goes to one element and remaining four goes to one each, or and alternatively, two elements of this set goes to one element, two another element goes to one element, and remaining three element goes to one each, and three to one each. Three goes to one each. Now, in that case, if case one is required, that means we need to partition this set, we need to group this set in such a manner, that is, if there are seven elements, we let's say we make a case that is three elements and one element each, that is 1, 1, 1, 1. This can be done in how many ways? We can group them, seven elements in three elements and one each element. This will be equivalent to, grouping will be 7 factorial by 3 factorial and 1 factorial to the power 4 times 4 factorial. This is the way, number of ways we can group seven elements in a group of 3 and in four groups of one each. And in the similar manner, in second case, we need to groups seven elements in two groups of two each and three groups of one each. That is, it can be done in 2 factorial square, 1 factorial cube times 2 factorial, 3 factorial. Okay, now after grouping them in a group of 3 and one of each, we need to distribute them to these 5. These 5, that can be done in only simply 5 factorial. 5 factorial, that means in this case, mapping will be done in grouping, and after distributing them to these 5 elements, this will be into 5 factorial, and in the similar manner, this will be into 5 factorial. That is, beta is nothing but sum of these two. Beta is sum of these two cases, that is 7 factorial by 3 factorial times 4 factorial multiplied by 5 factorial plus 7 factorial divided by 2 factorial square, 2 factorial, 3 factorial times 5 factorial. and we need to find what is the value of beta minus alpha divided by 5 factorial. That will be, let's take 5 factorial common over here, 5 factorial. It will be 7 factorial by 3 factorial 4 factorial plus 7 factorial by 2 factorial square, 2 factorial cube into 3 factorial, okay, minus alpha. Alpha was 7p2, okay, this is 7 factorial by 2 factorial. Now let's take it as 7c2 all divided by 5 factorial. Now this cancel out, this is nothing but 7 into 6 into 5 by 6, that is 35, plus this will be 7 into 6 into 5 into 4, this 3 factor cancels out, this is 8, 3, 35 into 3, 105, and this is minus 7 into 6 and this is 3, 21. Now this simplifies to 105 plus 35, that is 140 minus 20, that is 119. Minus 119 will be the answer. Okay. This is again from 2018 Advanced Paper 2. It says in a high school, a committee has to be formed from a group of 6 boys and 5 girls, and you need to evaluate. Alpha 1 is the total number of ways in which the committee can be formed, such that it consists of 5 members and having exactly 3 boys and 2 girls. Alpha 2 be the total number of ways in which the committee can be formed, in which there are at least 2 members and having an equal number of boys and girls. Let's do it on board only. This is simply case of selection with restrictions, with constraints. It is the case of selection with constraints. It says there are 6 boys, M1, M2, M6, and 5 girls, G1 to G5, and alpha 1 denotes, first is alpha 1 denotes the total number of ways in which committee can be formed of 5 members having exactly 3 boys and 2 girls, that is exactly 3 boys from here and 2 girls from here. That is simply alpha 1 is nothing but 6C3 times 5C2. It is simple selection of 3 boys from the set of 6 boys and selection of 2 girls from the set of 5 girls, and this will be nothing but 20 times 10, 200. Alpha 1 is 200. Alpha 2 is the number of total number of ways of selecting a committee of at least 2 members having an equal number of boys and girls. At least 2 members, that means the possibilities are, if we select 1 boy and 1 girl, could be 2 boys and 2 girls, could be 3 boys and 3 girls, 4 boys, 4 girls, and 5 boys, 5 girls maximum. That is the possibility. In how many ways you can select 1 boy and 1 girl from this set? It will be nothing but 6C1 and times 5C1, or plus 6C2 times 5C2, or plus 63 times 5C3, 64 times 5C4, and this will be 65 times 5C5. This is the answer. Now again it is a binomial series, hence you can add up this series using single binomial coefficient. As it will be selection of one object, selection of one boy out of 6 boys and one girl out of 5 girls. You may consider it as 5C4 also. You can consider it as 5C4 as a binomial coefficient. 5C1 is same as 5C4. To make this and this as constant, that is 1 plus 4. Now you consider it as 5C3. You consider this as 6C2 times 5C3. That means selection of 2 boys and 3 girls. Selection of 2 boys and 3 girls. So over here you select 1 boy and 4 girls. That means a total of 5 students from a class of 11 students. In this case you have 6C2, 5C2 implies 2 boys and 2 girls, but if you write 5C2 in terms of 5C3, that means it makes 2 boys selected from 6 boys and 3 girls selected from 5 girls. That means again, there are class of 11 students, you are selecting 5 students. In all these cases, you are selecting out of 11 students, 5 students. But one case is missing, that is if we have, this will be nothing but first term will be 6, in this manner, the first term will be 6C0 5C5. That is selection of 0 boys over here and 0 girl over here, that is also an even case, that is this case is missing. That means altogether there will be, this will be 11C, 11C you have 4, 5, 11C5, 11C5 minus first case, that is 1. This is the answer, that is 11 and 2, 10, 9, 8, 7 divided by 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 minus 1. Alpha 2 is nothing but 461. Alpha 3 is what? Alpha 3 is number of ways in which a committee can be formed such that the committee consists of 5 members, at least 2 of them being girls. At least 2 girls. Okay, consisting of how many members? 5. Now it says 5 members, at least 2 of them is girls. That is, let's say 2 girls and 3 boys. Now 3 girls, let's say 2 boys consisting of 5 members, 4 girls and over here it will be 1 boy and 5 girls, 0 boy. Again a case of binomial binomial series, it will be 6C3 times 5C2. Now it will be 6C2 times 5C3. 6C1 times 5C4 and 6C0 times 5C5. That means in all these cases you are selecting out of 11 students, 5 students again. And is there any case missing over here? That is 5C1, 6C4. Yes, there are case missing. Let's compute it brute force only. That is, it is 20 times 10, 200. This will be 15 times 10, 150. This will be 6 into 5, 30, and this is only one way. It will be 350, 380, 381. 381 will be the answer. That is alpha 3 is 381. Alpha 4, the last case, it says total number of ways in which the committee can be formed such that a number of committee of 4 members can be formed. Committee of 4 members having at least 2 girls. Having at least 2 girls, at least 2 again, at least 2 girls, but it further says that both M1 and G1, that is M1 and G1 are not together, are not in the committee together. Okay, let's consider at least 2 girls and committee of 4. Let's make all these cases, that is if it is 2 girls only and 2 boys, committee of 4. At least 2 girls, let's say 3 girls, 1 boy, and if we have 4 girls over here, 4 girls and let's say 0 boy. This can be done in how many ways? This will be 6C2 times 5C2 plus 6C1 times 5C3 and lastly 5C4. This will be your 15 times 10, 150 plus 6 into 10, 60 plus 5, it comes out to be 215. But from this 215, we must subtract those cases in which that M1 and G1 comes in the committee, that is they selected for a committee. We need to subtract it, the cases in which M1 and G1 are there. Now in this case, if M1 is there, G1 is there, then we need to select one boy further. M1 is already there. We are taking the cases in which M1 and G1 are there. One boy and one girl. One boy and one girl cases. That is, out of 5 boys, one girl. Boy is selected 5C1. And one girl from 4 girls, 4C1. Over here again, if we select one boy we need to and one girl, that means we need to select further 2 girls. That is from 4, we need to select 4C2. And one boy, M1 and G1 case will not be there because there is no boy over here. This will be 20 plus 6, 26. We need to subtract 26 from it. It will be 189. Okay, this is the answer. Now that is alpha 1 is 200. Okay, you need to match. There is a code over here. You need to match alpha 1 with alpha 1 matched with you have alpha 1 comes out to be 200. Alpha 1 is 200. That is p goes to 4. P goes to 4. Q goes to alpha 2 comes out to P 461. That is Q goes to 6. P goes to 4. Q goes to 6 makes C. And in that case, the answer key over here is C. R goes to 5. S goes to 2. Okay. Next is you need to find number of words of length 10 which needs to be formed from A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, and X be the number of such words where no letter is repeated, and Y be the number of such words where exactly one letter is repeated twice and no other letter is repeated. We need to find value of Y by NX. Again, a case of selection with constraint. It says, total letters available in the set are A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, 10 letters, and we need to find 10 letter words only, 10 letter words, 10 letter words, whereas X denotes the number of words with no letter repeated. That is, clearly X will be nothing but 10 factorial, permutation of all these A to J, 10. Now, Y denotes number of 10 letter words in which exactly one letter is repeated twice and no other letter is repeated further. Let's assume A is repeated twice, that is AA, and as there is no other letter repeated further and we need to form 10 letter words, we must drop one of the letters from the remaining 9 letters. Let's say J. It is, let's say, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. Let's say this is the word having one letter repeated twice and no other letter is repeated further. That means from this set of letters, we have two special letters. Let's say in this case, the two special letters are A, which is repeated twice, and one special letter which is not there in the word, that is J. Let's select those two letters from this set, that is 10C2. We select those letters, two special letters. Of them, if we select, let's say, B and D as two special letters, as B and D. Now, we further multiplied with 2, because if we have B and D as these two special letters, of them, one is repeated twice, one is missing. That means it could be either BB is there and D is not there, or DD is there, B is not there. Okay, let's consider this case when BB is there, D is not there. That means B is repeated twice over here now, and D is not there, D is not present. That means we have selected. Now, in this case, selected case will be BB, then we have A, C, and D is not there, E, F, G, H, I, J. This is the selection now. Now, we need to permute them to get our words, favorable words. That means it can be permuted like this. That will be 10 factorial by 2 factorial. This is the value of Y. 10C2 times 2 times 10 factorial, that is nothing but 10C2 is 10 into 9 by 255, 10 into 9, 5, 45 times 10 factorial. Why is this? We need to find value of y by 9x. That will be nothing but 45 times 10 factorial divided by 9 times 10 factorial. Five is the answer key. Okay, it is from 2017 advanced paper. It says S be the set consisting of 9 element 1 to 9, K is 1 to 5, NK denotes the number of subsets of S, each having 5 elements out of which exactly K are odd. We need to find sum of Ni's, that is N1 to N5. S is 1, 2, 3, 4, so and so forth, 9. And NK denotes number of subsets of S, number of subsets of S, this dot number of subsets of S having exactly number of subsets of S having five elements, of which k number of elements are odd, k number of odd elements. Okay, now let's consider n1. N1 means, n1 implies, by this definition, n1 implies there will be one odd number. N1 consists of one odd number and must be four even numbers. Now over here, number of odd number will be 5, number of odds are 5, and number of even numbers are 4. Okay, we need to select one odd and four even. That is, one odd will be 5c1, and four even out of four even, that is 4c4, that is 5. Number of such subsets will be 5. Now n2, similar manner, it will be two odd and remaining even, that is three even out of five. Two odds will be 5c2, and three even will be again 4c3. Again a case of binomial, you may consider it as a single binomial coefficient also, maybe. Now it will be 5c2 into 4c3, it will be 10 times 4, 40, and 3 will be, similar manner, 3 odd and 2 even, and that is nothing but 5c3 times 4c2, 10 into 6, 60, and 4 will be, and 4 is 4 odds and 1 even. 4 odd, 1 even will be 5c4 times 4c1, that is 20, and lastly n5 will be 5 odd and 0 even, that is 5c5, that is 1, and if you add them, that is 126 will be the answer. That is, answer key will be D. Okay, now it is from 2016 advanced paper. It says a debate club consists of 6 girls and 4 boys. A team of 4 members is to be selected from this club, including the selection of a captain from among those 4 members only for the team. If the team has to include at most one boy, that is again the case of selection with restrictions. Now it says there are 6 boys and 4 girls. 4 members team to be selected, 4 members to be selected, 4 selection of 4, 4 to be selection. Now further it says there is at most one boy, that means let's consider the team has to include at most one boy. That means it could be one boy and 3 girls, or it could be 0 boy, that means there is no boy in the selection, and all girls, that is 4 girls will be there. 4 girls will be there. Okay, now in this case, this selection can be done in, let's say, 6c1 times 4c3, and this selection can be done in 4c4 only. But in all these cases, we need to make a captain from the selected team. That is, if we select, let's say, B1 and 3 girls as G1, G2, G3, this is the team selected from in this case. This is the, let's say, one of the cases of these cases, that is one boy, that is B1, and G1, G2, G3. But we need to make a captain from it. That is, we can take, let's say, consider B1 as the captain and G1, G2, G3 as the members, G1 as the captain, or G2 as the captain, or G3 as the captain. That is, this team must be in the must have 4 cases in which B1 is the captain, or G1 as the captain, or G2 as the captain, or G3 as the captain. We must multiply it with 4. In the similar manner, we multiply this with 4, and this will be the required selections. That will be 6 into 4, 24 into 4, 96, plus it will be 4, 100 ways. 6c1, if the team has to include at most one boy, 3 girls, and 6c, okay, sorry, I missed this, that is, there are 6 girls and 4 boys over here. I made a mistake. 6 girls, 4 boys. Now it will be 6C3 and 4C1 times 4. And over here there are 4 girls. That means 6C4. This will be 20 into 4. 80 into 4. 320. And this is nothing but 15 into 4. That is 60. That is 380 possibilities. So you must note this mistake also, because I made a mistake. That is, I use 6 as number of boys and 4 as number of girls. The paper setter must give that option also. Now it says, let n be the number of ways in which 5 boys and 5 girls can be stand in a queue in such a way that all the girls stand in consecutively in a queue. Now let m be the number of ways in which 5 boys and 5 girls can stand in a queue in such a way that exactly 4 girls stand consecutively in a queue. You need to find value of m by n. It says there are 5 boys and 5 girls. There are 5 boys, 5 girls. And first case is, m is the number of ways in which 5 boys and 5 girls can stand in a queue, all in such that all girls are consecutive. That means with, let's say, B1, B2, B3, B4, B5, and all girls are consecutive. That is G1, G2, G3, G4, G5. Let's club them and consider it as a single object. And let's arrange them in a queue, in a row. Let's say there are now 1, 2, 5, and this is a single object will be 6 factorial. These can be arranged in 6 factorial. Now, wherever this, in this arrangement, 6 factorial arrangement, wherever this single object goes, we can arrange inside this object as 5 factorial. The girls will be arranged in 5 factorial ways. This is the value of m. Now, n denotes number of ways in which these 5 boys and 5 girls can stand in a queue such that exactly 4 girls stand consecutively. Now, out of these 5, exactly 4 are consecutive. Now, let's consider, let's select 4 girls from it. Let's say 5C4 first. 5C4, it could be anyone, any 4, for G1, G2, G3, G4, or G1, G3, G4, G5, any 4, and 1 is separated. Now, we have a selection of 4 girls. Selection of 4 girls, let's say G1, G2, G3, G4, and let's say G5. And 5 boys also, 5 B1, B2, B3, B4, B5. I've selected 4 girls and make a group of it, let's say group X. And we want number of cases in which these can be arranged now in a queue, such that these 4 girls are consecutive, but exactly 4 girls are consecutive. That means in this arrangement, we want this group and G5 must be separated. This group X and G5 must be separated. Now, in that case, let's arrange these 5 boys first. That is B1, B2, B3, B4, B5. Let's arrange them. This can be done in 5 factorial ways. These 5 boys can be arranged in 5 factorial ways. Now, that will create 6 gaps between them, 6 partitions, 6 gaps between them. And on these gaps, if we put this X object and G5, then exactly 4 girls will be together. That means we need 2 gaps from these 6 gaps. That means we first select 2 gaps from these 6 gaps. And on, let's say, the 2 selected gaps, either that X object comes over here and G5 comes over here, or G5 comes over here, X object comes over here, that is 2 factorial into. And wherever that X object goes, it consists of 4 girls that can be arranged in 4 factorial ways. Now, this is the value of n. And we need to find value of m by n. What is the value of m by n? That is 6 factorial times 5 factorial. That is m divided by this quantity. This is nothing but 5. 5 times 5 factorial. That is 5 and 4 factorial. These 2 becomes 5 factorial times 5 factorial. 5 factorial times 5 factorial times 6C2 times 2 factorial, that is nothing but 6C2 is 15 into 30. 30. Now let's drop this 5 factorial, and this will be 6 pi 1 by 5. We need to find mn. Okay, again, let's say this is n, this is m, and we need to find m by n. M by n is this by this, that is, this is, okay, this is n by m. We need to find m by n. We need to find m by n, that is 5. That is 5 again. Answer key will be 5. Okay, now this is question from Advanced 2014. It says, let n is greater than or equal to 2 be an integer and n distinct points are selected on a circle. Join each pair of points by a line segment and color the line segment joining every pair of adjacent points by blue and the rest by red. That is, adjacent points are colored as blue and rest, that is, diagonals by red. And if you need, it is given that number of red and blue segments are equal. What is the value of n? Now, n is greater than or equal to 2. It says, in a, on a circle, n points are marked. Let's say 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.10 minus 2, 0.10 minus 1, 0.10. N points are marked. And further it says, any two adjacent pairs, adjacent points by blue. Any two adjacent points by blue. That is, this is joined by blue. This segment is joined by blue, this segment is joined by blue, at any two adjacent points. And non-adjacent points are joined like in red color. Let's say this is the scenario. And further it says number of blue line segment is same as number of red line segment. That means number of blue line segment will be nothing but n. Number of blue line segment. Number of red line segments will be, all together will be, now any two points can be selected in any, how many ways? NC two ways. Of them, n pairs will be of adjacent points. That means you must have NC two minus n. These are the number of red lines, and this is the number of blue lines. And it says these are same. That is NC two. That is n minus n, n minus 1 by 2 equals 2n, and that simplifies to n is equal to 5. That simplifies to n is equal to 5. That is the answer key. Now, this is the question from Advanced 2014. It says, n1, n2, n3, n4, n5 be positive integers such that n1, 2, n5 sum up to 20, and we need to find the number of distinct 5 tuples, that is n1, n2, n3, n4, n5. How many 5 tuples are there? Which satisfies this? Ordered n1 less than n2 less than n3 less than n4 so and so forth less than n5 such that n1 plus n2 plus n3 plus n4 plus n5 add up to 20. These 5 add up to 20 and they are positive integers. Ni's are positive integers, that means they belongs to set of natural numbers. Ni's belongs to natural set of natural numbers. Now, as you can see, Ni's belongs to a set of natural numbers. This must be greater than or equal to 1. This n1 must be greater than or equal to 1. Now, n2 is greater than n1 implies n2, if n1 is 1, n2 must be 2. That means n2 must be greater than or equal to 2. That means the hidden constraint over here are n1 is greater than or equal to 1, n2 is greater than or equal to 2, n3 is more than n2. Hence, n3 must be at least 1 more than n2. That means n3 must be greater than or equal to 3, n4 must be greater than or equal to 4, and n5 must be greater than or equal to 5. Now let's rewrite this equation. Let's rewrite this equation by taking n1 minus 1 as, let's say, w1, or you may say n1 as w1 plus 1. Similarly, ni as wi plus i. Wi plus i. This equation boils down to, let's say, w1 plus 1 plus w2 plus 2 plus W3 plus 3 W4 plus 4 and W5 plus 5 equals 20, and that is equivalent to W1 plus W2 plus W3 plus W4 plus W5, sum of these WIs must be is equal to 5. Whereas now the constraints are W1 is less than equal to W2, W1 can be equal to W2, is less than equal to W3, less than equal to W4, less than equal to W5, and they are now non-negative integers. They are now non-negative integer whose sum is 5. That means now the case is simpler, because if you take, let's say W5 as 5, let's say W5 is 5. That means in that case, if you add these two 5, and these must be 0 only. WIs from 1 to 4, W1, W2, W3, W4, all of them must be 0. All of them must be 0. Now, this is when if you have W1 is 0, W1 is 0, that means N1 is 1, N1 is 1, N1 is 1, N2 in that case will be 2, N3 will be 3, N4 will be 4, and N5 will be W5 plus 5, that is 10. That is 10. For each of these WIs tuples, you get a tuple of N1 to N5. That means there is a 1 to 1 mapping. You need to find number of solution of this equation will be same as number of solution of this equation under the same constraint. Now, next possibility is you cannot take this as 5, because in that case this constraint fails, that is W4 is less than equal to W5. Now, next possibility is there is no maximum 5. Let's say maximum possible is 4. Maximum possible is 4. If we take W5 as 4, now the 1 goes here, it will be 0, 0, 0. Now, next possible is, let's say 3, maximum is 3, and maximum of number taken is, maximum number will be taken by W5 only. That is, this is 3, this is 2, and let's say 0, 0, 0. It could be 3, 1, 1, 0, 0. Okay, next possibility is, let's say maximum is 2. Now, remaining 3 will be either 1, 1, 1, okay, only possibility is 1, 1, 1, and the last case will be 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Now, let me elaborate this. That is, what is this case? This case means N1 is 1, N1 is 1, N2 will be 2 plus 0, that is 2, N3 will be 3 plus 1, that is 4, N4 will be 4 plus 1, that is 5, and 5 must be 8, and that add up to 20. That add up to 20 only. These are the only cases possible, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, I have missed one case, that is 5, 4, 1, 4, 1, 3, 2, okay, 3, 1, 1. That is 3 over here. I have written 3, 1, 1. 5, all zeros, 4, 1, that's it. That is 3 and 2. All zeros, 3, double 1, all zeros. Then we have 2. Okay, I missed that case. That is, there is a possibility if it is 2 and 1 goes here. That is 2, 1, 0, 0. This is another possibility which I have missed. That is, these are the only possibility which make this as 20. You need to count brute force only in this case. Answer is 7. Now, it is from 2014 advance. It says 6 cards and 6 envelopes are numbered 1 to 6. And cards are to be placed in envelopes so that each envelope contains exactly one card and no card is placed in the envelope bearing the same number. That is the case of derangement. Now, further it says, moreover, the card numbered 1 is always placed in the envelope 2. Now, in how many ways we can do this? We can do this. It says there are 6 cards, card 1, card 2, card 3, card 4, card 5, card 6, and envelope 1, envelope 2, envelope 3, envelope 4, envelope 5, envelope 6. And no card goes to respective envelope, CI won't go to envelope I. That means, and further it says number C1 goes to envelope 2 only. C1 goes to envelope 2 only. In how many ways we can do this? That is, Ci won't go to envelope I and C1 must go to envelope 2. C1 must go to envelope 2. Now, if we find, if there is no constraint like this, that is C1 goes to envelope 2, only constraint is Ci won't go to envelope I. That means this is the clear case of derangement of 6 object, that is number of ways in which 6 objects can be deranged is D6. That will be 6 factorial, 1 by 2 factorial minus 1 by 3 factorial plus 1 by 4 factorial minus 1 by 5 factorial plus 1 by 6 factorial. That will be 720, 1 by 2 minus 1 by 6 plus 1 by 24 minus 1 by 120 plus 1 by 720. That will be 360 minus 120 plus, this is by 2, this is by 3 by 4, 30 by 5, 6 by 7 plus 1. That will be 391 minus 126. That is 265. D6 is 265, but if there is a constraint that C1 goes to envelope 2 only, now this denotes what? This denotes what? In how many ways I can derange 6 objects unconstrained? That is, C1 is either in A2 or in A3 or in E4 or in E5 or in E6. That is equally probable, equal probabilities are there. That is, C1 goes to E2 or in E3 or in E4 or in E6. That is, there are 5 such cases. That means the required answer, that is when C1 goes to E2 only, C1 goes to E2 only, number of ways of this, number of this plus C1 goes to E3, number of ways of this, add up to number of ways C1 goes to E6 will be nothing but 265, and they are all of them are equal. Hence, number of ways in which C1 goes to E2 only, number of ways in which C1 goes to E2 only will be 265 divided by 5. That will be 53. That will be 53. This is one way. Other way of looking at it is, it says C1 goes to E2. C1 goes to E2. Now let's first put C2. Now if C2 goes to E1, that is one possibility, then we just need to derange these 4 objects in these 4 envelopes. That means under the case when C1 is in E2 already in the question. But if we take a case, another case, if C2 goes to E1, then there is a derangement of 4 objects, that is D4, and that is 9. And if that is one case, and second case is C2 won't go to E1. C2 is not placed in E1. That means in that case, C2 is not in E1, and these C3 is not in E3, C4 is not in E4, C5 is not in E5, C6 is not in E6. That is, again, there are 5 cards to be placed and there are 5 envelopes and there are 5 constraints. That is, C2 won't go to E1 only. That means this is the case of derangement of 5 objects, that is D5, and that is 44. And if we add them, the required answer, this same 53 will be nothing but D4 plus D5. And that is also D6 is also 5 times this. That implies this is 53. That is, answer key is C. And this question is from 2013. It says, consider a set of 8 vectors AI cap plus BJ cap plus CK cap, where ABC belongs to 1 or minus 1. ABC belongs to this set of 2 elements, either 1 or minus 1. And we need to find in how many ways we can select 3 non-coplanar vectors from set V. Set V consists of AI cap plus BJ cap plus CK cap. A and B belongs to set 1 or minus 1. This set clearly contains, if we have A can take any either of these 2 values, A can be filled in 2 ways, B can be filled in 2 ways, C can be filled in 2 ways. This set consists of 8 vectors, that is I cap plus J cap plus K cap, minus I cap, minus J cap, minus K cap. I cap plus J cap minus K cap, I cap minus I cap minus J cap plus K cap, I cap minus J cap plus K cap, minus I cap plus J cap minus K cap, minus I cap plus J cap plus K cap, and I cap minus J cap minus K cap. This is the set, and it says in how many ways we can select three non-coplanar vectors. Now, clearly, a selection of three vectors won't contain these two vectors simultaneously, because in that case, if these two are there, the determinant definitely vanishes, because this consists of component 1, 1, 1, and this vector consists of component minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. In the similar manner, these two won't be there in the same selection, these two together won't be there in the same selection, these two won't be there in the same selection. That means for first vector you have how many choices? For first vector you have choices from these eight vectors, we can choose any one of them for first vector. For first vector we can choose any one of them. Let's say we choose this one. Now if we choose this one, this won't be in the selection. Because if this and this come together, they are non-coplanar. Let's drop this. Now from the remaining six, we can choose any one of them again. Let's choose this one. Now from that means in this case this one will be there. Now further, now from these four we can choose any one of them. That is 8 times 6 times 4. But this selection also has arrangement of the selected vectors. That is in this case we select first this. In these six, let's say we select this one as the second. And from the remaining four, we selected this one as the third. But we need just the number of selections, But in first case, if we selected this one, from the remaining six, we selected this one. And from the remaining four, we selected this one. The same selection will be there, selection of three objects. That means we must divide this by the arrangements, that is six. That comes out to be 32. But we must check whether the selected now, the now selected vector will be coplanar or not. That is, let's say this set vector, this vector, this vector. Now clearly this is the case. Let's say these two are along the body diagonal. That is, I cap plus j cap plus k cap is this. J minus I cap minus j cap minus k cap will be this vector. Similarly, this is body diagonal. And let's say this one is another body diagonal and this one is another body diagonal. Okay, that means the selected three vectors will be along the body diagonals, hence cannot be coplanar, clearly not coplanar. These are the 32 selections which are non-coplanar, selection of three non-coplanar vectors, and that can be represented as 2 to the power 5. And that was what is asked, that is value of P is 5. That is the official answer key. Thank you.